Dear all, welcome and thank you for tuning in to this video. I'm Dr. Loyal Zerbi. I am in this video going to answer a question I received from one of the channel subscribers. She asked about my advice about selecting the best minor for her majoring in biomedical engineering to improve her chances in finding a job after graduation. This is a very important question and I thought that this is something I would like to create a video to answer. Welcome. I am a faculty in the field of biomedical engineering. I create content related to science, technology, engineering, and mathematics in healthcare and its applications in healthcare. So if you're interested in such topics, subscribe to the channel and hit the notification bell so that you receive a notification every time I post a video. Regarding the question that I wanted to answer today, it's really a very important question. Usually, people in studying engineering, they don't have a major and a minor. But in liberal arts institutions, specifically in the United States of America and the West, you have liberal arts institutions where they provide you actually with the breadth and depth of knowledge. So you have a breadth of knowledge in different topics of your interest, and also you have depth in a specific field. All students have to have a major and a minor. In engineering as well, so if we have five disciplines of engineering in the school that I'm teaching in, and each engineering student has to have a major and a minor. Usually, as I mentioned before, engineering disciplines, they don't have majors and minors, but I'm one of the guys who feel that it's really important to have a major and a minor if you are studying engineering. You will need to add 12 to 18 credit hours to your curriculum in order to have a minor embedded inside the program that you should be enrolled in. What are the minors that are really, really helpful for engineers in general, and specifically for biomedical engineering? First one, classical minor, which is mathematics. In engineering, usually, they should have three courses in calculus, one course in differential equations, and one course in statistics. And this is going to give you a minor in mathematics. And that's the classical expectation from all engineers. The second minor that I advise people, actually, and students pursuing engineering degrees is to go into computer science and programming. We live in the automation age, and programming and coding is very, very important for all engineers now who wants to thrive actually in the 21st century. So computer science and programming is a good minor to pursue. The next minor that I suggest for a student to do is economy or accounting. We have a lot of engineers who, after they finish their bachelor degree, they do master's in business administration, especially if they want to run businesses and be in the middle and upper managements in their management positions in their companies. So economy and accounting is really a good minor for engineers as well. Also, another important minor for engineers is entrepreneurship. I always tell my students that the expectations from engineers is to solve problems. And once we have a solution for a problem, engineers need to file a patent for their idea and prototype or project that they built, and then they can license the patent and or start up their own company. And that's why I like entrepreneurship. And a lot of universities are now offering majors and minors in entrepreneurship. I suggest for all engineers, specifically biomedical engineers, because it's a research-based discipline with a lot of innovation in it, to minor in entrepreneurship. If we want to go into the classical field of, or topics to minor in, one of the most important one for biomedical engineering, especially biomedical engineers who are interested in pursuing a career in medical imaging, is physics. Physics is really a good minor to have if you are interested, especially if you are a biomedical engineer and we want to do medical imaging. We usually have 40% of our biomedical engineering graduates pursue medical degree, 40% pursue graduate school, and only 20 to 30% go to industry. So if you are interested in medical school or vet school or dentistry school, it's really a good thing to minor in biology. That's a very good minor for you because it will give you breadth of knowledge in biology, top of the basics, which is cell biology and anatomy and physiology. The next one is chemistry. If you are interested in biomaterials and tissue engineering, we actually expect from biomedical engineers to have solid foundation in chemistry. So if you are minoring in chemistry, you're going to take organic and inorganic chemistry. So these things are going to help you a lot if you are going to pursue an advanced degree. The next minor that I suggest for biomedical engineering, specifically and engineering in general, is exercise sciences. So if you are interested in physical therapy and occupational therapy, exercise sciences actually is a good minor to have. And the school that I teach in offer this these programs as well. The last suggestion I would like to give actually for a minor is neuroscience. And this, if the school and that you're in is offering in neuroscience, this is really a good minor if you're interested in doing grad school as well and getting more and more into the brain activity and designing and developing solutions for neuroscience and neuroapplications. So all these are top, you know, scientific topics. I don't know what is it that your school is offering or university is offering. Does it offer any of these as minors? Tell me that and, you know, share it with everybody and the community in the comment section below. I would like to hear from you about that. Now, all of these scientific minors, they're good, but also we would like our engineers also to have non-scientific minors. Students can minor in arts and or music. And actually, the reason why we are encouraging biomedical engineering students and engineering students in general to minor in these topics is that because of innovation creativity. Creativity and innovation, to me actually, and to a lot of people, is that you have different disciplines and different interests and you bring them together in order to provide a solution for a common unmet need, right? So if you are having a biomedical engineering degree and knowledge and as well music, minor in music, you can use the music actually in order to come up with solutions to improve people's life and, you know, well-being and, you know, live healthier, longer, and more productive, especially in the psychology field. And that goes the same for arts as well. So if you are an engineer or a biomedical engineer and you can combine art and music into actually your solutions and your products and, you know, the things that you develop, that will be an awesome, innovative, creative way of approaching and solving problems. We also encourage people who are interested in intellectual properties, if they want to be patent lawyers, actually to go and have a degree in law or to minor something in law. I know in the United States of America, it is actually, you need to have a bachelor degree to pursue and study law and to become a lawyer. But other countries around the world, sometimes they offer that you have a minor in law or politics or history that can help you actually if you want to become a patent lawyer. Remember that most patent lawyers in the United States of America are engineers. They have a bachelor degree in engineering. So this is a field that also we encourage biomedical engineers and engineers in general to minor in as well. One of the other things that we tell students that there are a lot of scholarships offered to minor actually in music and arts, and so this is another thing that to consider when you do your bachelor degree, undergrad degree. So if you watched till this point, thank you so much for watching. I hope this was helpful. If you find it helpful, give it the video a thumbs up and share it. And if you would like, you'd like to hear more about this, these topics and this content, subscribe to the channel and hit the notification bell so that you get notified every time I post a video. I wanted to hear from you as well. So keep your questions coming. I usually answer all the questions I receive, and also I would like from you to hear from you about what do you think about what I provided in this video. Do you agree? Do you disagree? What minor do you have, and what minors your school or university is offering? It's really interesting to hear, the feedback from different places around the world. I'm going to leave links to my socials in the description below of this video, as well as links to ways to support the channel so that I can make more video and more content like this one. Thank you so much for watching. Until the next video, bye.